Amen. So this is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
My Bible,
my Bible
is the word of God.
Word.
I agree with God.
With God.
I am more than a conqueror.
I'm
above all that.
I'm
not beneath.
I'm
the head.
I'm
not the tail.
I agree with God.
Jesus.
Jesus
is the glory.
I'm
the lifter.
Above
my head.
He's
the author.
And
the finisher.
And
of my faith.
All my
I agree with God.
In
Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Dear Lord is worthy.
Hallelujah.
Worthy to be praised.
Hallelujah.
From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the name of the Lord shall be praised.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory be to God in the highest.
Hallelujah.
Loving people in a godly way. Loving people in a godly way. Thank you, Jesus. Loving people in a godly way. Sometimes we have friends, when they are nice to us, we're nice back to them. When they're not as nice to us, then we tend not to be nice to them at all, or to pay them back. Well, unfortunately, the love of God is not conditional, it's unconditional. Because the Lord causes his sun to shine on the just and the unjust. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
A lot of people say they are Christians, but there's a missing part of it. The scripture says, Romans chapter 10, verse 9, that if you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus Christ as the Lord and your Savior, and believe in your heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead, you shall be saved. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. As the scripture says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. If we shall confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus, and shall believe in our heart, that God has raised us from the dead, we shall be saved. For with the heart, man believes unto righteousness. So if it's not in your heart, it'll be difficult to walk right.
Mm-hmm. That's the truth, Pastor.
If it's not in your heart, then you just run through the motion. The connection of your mouth agreeing with your heart is what how somebody gets saved. It's not enough to go to the front and just say it with your mouth and don't really mean it. Because some people are putting you under pressure to confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus. You have to believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead. If you do that, there's a connection. When there's a connection, there's an infilling of there's the Holy Spirit inside of you. Hallelujah. When a person is born again, inside of you is the Holy Spirit of God. When you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead. The problem is this. If you truly born again, it will be very, very difficult for us to live a shabby life. We're going to live a shabby, terrible life. Every time you deviate from what God said don't do, you feel so terrible. Because the Bible says no one that is born of God continuously sin and enjoy it. For the righteous sin, they say you cannot continue in that. A person can sin. I'm not saying nobody can sin. But if you make it an habit, they will get a problem.
Yes,
it's not that you're not born again, or you need to go back to the drawing board and say, Lord, you know something? Create in me a clean heart. Renew the right spirit within me. Christianity is not something you say out of your mouth. It's how you live your life. I said, Christianity is not what you say out of your mouth. It's how you live your life.
Yeah,
when they saw Peter and the apostles, they perceived that they had been with Jesus when they saw their faith. When they saw their faith, they pursued their being with Jesus. They didn't say, oh, I'm a Christian, come and look at me. No. An apple tree doesn't make noise, just create the apple. Hallelujah. An apple tree doesn't say, come and look at me, I'm an apple tree. If you see a tree with no fruit, you can argue what kind of a tree that is. You can say, it's an apple tree, no, it's an orange tree. But if they have a fruit, then it removes all doubt. The fruit of the Spirit is love. Authentic love. But this shall men know that you are my disciples if you have love one for another.
Yeah.
I'm talking about the love of God for real.
Amen.
I'm talking about getting along with people.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, if you don't allow God to saturate our heart with his love, it'd be difficult to share what you don't have.
Mm.
So many people have been trying to share the love of God, but they have not settled down for God to. The Bible says that for the love of God is shed abroad in our heart by the Holy Spirit that is given unto us. For the love of God is shed abroad in our heart But the Holy Spirit has been given unto us the love of God. God said, you didn't love me first. I love you first. Yeah. And with that love that I have for you, love other people as I love you. You shall love the Lord your God. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your spirit, with all your everything. And then he said, love your neighbor as yourself. Mm-hmm. But you got to love God first.
Amen.
If you do not love your people or your neighbor that you can see, how can you say you love God that you can't see?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. If any man say, I love the Lord, and refuse to obey the word of God, the Bible says the love of God is not in him.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Jesus. So you have to start carefully. Make up your mind who you're going to serve. Make up your mind what you're going to do in life. Don't just say, I'm a Christian and I'm living a rapid life that brings disgrace to the kingdom of God.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. If you're a Christian, walk like it. Allow the Holy Spirit to live his life through us.
Yeah.
We're a Christian, not because we're trying to struggle, not to do wrong, but we die to save. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. I have to humble my heart before God so God can work on me. I have to humble my heart before God. God said, we're a new creation in Christ. We are a new creation. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory be to God.
Yeah.
We're living in the last days. How do I know that? People have tried to stray away from what the Bible says, to create their own appetite, something that will suit the people. The kind of doctrine that will make you go on sinning and be comfortable in the sin. I got a news for you. Christ will come back, the people will stay down. They won't go anywhere. It's called the rapture. You come back and the people, they're beating the tambourine and beating the drum to it. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank
you don't lower the standard of God to meet your need.
Amen.
You come up with the standard of God. You come up with the standard of God through the help of the Holy Spirit. God said, I will not leave you comfortless. God knows that we cannot live a godly life on our own. He said, I will not leave you comfortless, but I'm going to come to you in the person of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He alone is worthy. Worthy to be praised. Worthy to be praised. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the name of the Lord, it shall be praised.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. There are some few things we have to do in order for us to be able to love people like God loved them. And that is this. We have to submit our heart to God. We have to not make decisions based on what we think, but based on what God says. Thank you, Jesus. Anytime you choose to do what God says, you're going to face opposition. It comes with a warranty. If you're doing the will of God and you don't face any opposition, then you need to check yourself out to see if you're in faith.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. American Bible Society, there was this last week, they decided that if you're going to work for American Bible Society, you have to believe that the marriage is between a man and a woman. And you have to be celibate, you cannot be shacking, living together with people and do what the married people are doing and expect to still be saved and working with God.
Right.
But some people are mad because they said that. They said, but the LGBTQ, you leave them out. They said, Jesus Christ is exclusive, it's inclusive for everybody. I said, you just got to be missing it. Christ came to die for our sins. Christ came to separate the sinner from the sin, that's why he came.
Amen.
Not to go along with everybody else. He's not looking for a crowd. He's looking for people that want to be obedient to him.
Amen.
Nobody's going to force you to be saved.
Hallelujah.
Christ is not trying to lose his sleep over somebody that decided they don't want him. No. Absolutely no. He died already on the cross.
Yeah.
He was buried and he rose on the third day by the power of the Holy Spirit. He said, yes or no?
Yes.
I don't want you to be talking between two opinions. God is God, go with him if he's not leaving me alone.
Amen.
Don't be standing between and rattling the fence. Can't decide whether you saved or not. Hallelujah. The devil is a liar.
Amen.
He said, without holiness, no man shall see God. Without holiness, God is holy.
That's it.
And we need to know that. Hallelujah. Make up your mind. Choose this day open, you will serve. What are the God of the Amorite in whose land you are living? Or the God of the other side of the Jordan? But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. You have to make up your mind. Thank you, Jesus. He's slipping around and slipping and sliding and saying you're saved. God bless you. I just feel so sorry for you that you're taking him but you're out. It's called deception. Hallelujah. No one that is born of habitually sin and continue to live in it. You cannot. For the righteous seed is in you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He alone is worthy. In order to love people in a godly way, We have to be obedient to the scriptures. There are so many people that know the world backward and forward. They just can't live it. Quoting the scripture without living it is called a hypocrite. Because you have to decide what you're going to do.
Hallelujah.
It's not enough to know the scriptures.
Right.
You have to be obedient to the scripture, to humble our heart before under the scripture.
Yes.
Yeah.
Submit yourself under the mighty hand of God. Submit yourself therefore unto God and resist the devil, and he shall flee from you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
The word of God is not to make us comfortable, it's to make a change in our life forever.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. Tell me you're a Christian, somewhere along the line, I have to see that you are the salt of the earth. You know what's so interesting about the salt? When you put the salt in something, you don't see the salt, but you can taste the effect of the salt.
Yes.
They will not see Christ physically, but you can see the effect of his life in your life by the way you live. The preaching of the gospel does not come with the entire wisdom of man, but it comes in the demonstration of the Holy Ghost and of power, that your faith should not rest in the wisdom of man, but in the power of God.
Preach.
Hallelujah. Too many people trying to water down what the Bible says. You're out. But then in, you deserve. Deceived.
Right.
It's called deception.
Yeah.
You're not going to make God, you're not going to have God to get you in your own terms.
That's it.
You got his own standard.
Mm-hmm.
And without holiness, no man shall see God.
That's the truth, Pastor.
We have so many people that claim to be Christians, go to church, but live a raggedy life.
Mm-hmm.
Married, but do what the married folk do. They do all kind of everything else. And they think it's supposed to be okay because everybody else is doing it. That's what the Bible says. Wide is the gate that leads to destruction. And many find it. Why? Because it's easy.
Yeah.
It's called the doctrine of the devil that makes you comfortable in sin without no conviction.
Right.
And the going to the church will never make you a Christian. Give me a life to the God of the church will. Going to McDonald's will not make you a bugger. Going to the church will not make you a Christian. The worst thing a person can do is to go to church and live a worldly life. It's a miserable life. Because you don't know who's watching. He's trying to conduct and say, where am I? Or the world, okay, let's do it like the world. Where am I? The church? Or let's act like the church. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
He alone is worthy.
Okay.
Worthy to be praised.
Okay.
Thank you, Jesus. And now for us to love, like God wants us to love, we have to make up our mind. I have to make up my mind that, Lord, you know something? I don't want to live just a regular Christian life, just go to church and go home with no anointing. Christ died on the cross so we can fellowship with him.
Yes.
I said, Christ died on the cross so we can have a fellowship with him.
Yes.
We can have a fellowship with him. If you claim to love the Lord and you hate your brother, you are walking in darkness.
Yes.
You have not met God. You heard about him, but you haven't met him.
Hallelujah.
See, many people have heard about people, but you haven't met them personally. And to meet God is to love God. Because God is love.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thanks. We're an ambassador. You represent the kingdom of God.
Hallelujah.
How are you going to represent love when you hate him?
Mm-hmm.
For we're living at peace, rather for all men.
Yeah,
the early church didn't have any problem with holiness. They knew that whatever the Bible said, that's what they go by. Now we try to water down everything. American Bible Society said marriage is between a man and a woman. And before we can employ you to work with us, we have to make sure that you're not shacking. We have to make sure that you'll be two men or two women talking about we're trying to get married. And people got mad. Some people got mad. They said, that's terrible. But thank God for the other person that was talking. He said, wait a minute. He said, the people that donate to this American Bible Society, they believe in the biblical doctrine. And so, it behooves them. Don't get away from what you believe just because to make everybody happy.
Right.
I said, don't get away from what the Bible says to make everybody happy. If you do, you just got you missing God, you're missing target.
Yeah.
You go to a club, no change. Christianity is not a religion of, what? How can I put it? Of compromise.
Right.
It's a relationship with God. It's a personal relationship with God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God in the highest. He alone is worthy. Worthy to be praised. God is a very awesome God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. He alone is worthy. Psalm 51 verse 10. You know what he said? When David messed around with Bathsheba, Uriah's wife, and Nathan came to talk to him. He said, Lord, against you they have I sinned. I've done wrong, Lord. Forgive me. The problem is this. Many of us, when we do wrong, we try to argue with God that we're okay because everybody's doing it. Just because everybody's doing it doesn't make it right. You understand that, right?
Amen.
You gotta be in line with what the Bible says. If you're a Christian now, if you say you're a Christian now, okay. Thank you, Jesus. He alone is worthy. Worthy to be praised. The Bible says, create in me a clean heart, Lord. Renew the right spirit within me. Against you only have I done this wrong. There's gotta be some kind of conviction inside of us when something's wrong. If there's no conviction, then maybe there's no seed to begin with. A good farmer knows before he can water the ground, you have to plant the seed first.
Yeah.
First, tilt the ground. God said, I want your heart to be tender towards me. The day you hear my voice, do not harden your heart as the day of provocation.
Yeah,
people hear the word and they get mad because that's not what they want to hear. Because it's not suiting them. Because it's convicting them. God is not coming to make you happy.
Amen.
Or to come and suit you. That's not why I'm coming. I have to tell you that. Thank you, Jesus. I'm not preaching to you. God is using me to preach to us. I hope you understand that.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
He alone is worthy. Glory be to God in the highest. When we get away from what the Bible says, then there's no conviction left. When we get away from what the Bible says, then there's no hope for the future for us. For the mystery of the gospel is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Jesus Christ came, and he died, and he was buried, and on the third day he rose according to the scriptures. Hallelujah. That's the first important, the most important thing in the Bible. Jesus Christ came, he died, he was buried, and he rose on the third day by the power of the Holy Spirit. That's 1 Corinthians 15, verse 3. By the way, thank you, Jesus. So we try to go against what the Bible says. We don't say it, but we just actually just go against what the Bible says, and we still trying to be in. Thank you, Jesus. God don't want to be struggling within. Make up your mind. Whether you're going to go with God or you're not going to go with God. Don't be in between. It's Church of Laodicea. Amen. Lukewarm. God said, I wish you'd be cold of heart. But you're lukewarm. Like a lukewarm milk. He said, I'm going to spill you out of my mouth. Change. Return to your first love. Walk with God again.
Hey, thank you.
Let your Christianity be evident by the way you live your life, not by what you say. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
If you live your life according to the word of God, through the help of the Holy Spirit, then people will see the love of God in your life. They say, I can put my finger on it, but there's something different about you. There's something very different about you. I can put my finger, but there's something very different about you. People know when they see a real, and they know when they see a fake. Thank you. If you go to the club with everybody else and party and do everything else, Monday to Friday and on Sunday morning, you wear your sanctimonious dress or suit, or praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Where were you last night? In the club? Look at the problem.
Amen.
I got one amen. Thank you, sister. I know I can count on you. Thank you, Jesus. When we get away from what the Bible says, then we get away from hope. Because God is love. God came to give us hope. He came to give us joy. He came to give us fulfillment. He came to change our destiny forever. He came to give us, just help us out. So we can walk in our purpose in God. So when people go against what the Bible says, then they are left with no hope. 2016, 45,000 people committed suicide in the United States. 45,000. What's wrong? Well, if you don't have Christ, the hope of glory, or you don't know you have him, then you have no hope. Don't kick the Bible out of school, please. If you say, resent what the Bible says, no problem. You're going to be faced with overwhelming situation. Let me tell you something. The Bible says, with men, some things are impossible, but not with God. If you kick God out of your life, then you'll be facing the impossibility you cannot help. You can't do anything, because you don't have God. So say, not with God. Let me say it slowly. The Bible says, with men, some things are impossible, but not with God. So if you resent God, and you are facing with things that are overwhelming, then you don't have God to help you to overcome what you're going through.
Wow.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
The goal of this command, this is 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 5, let's take a look at it. Thank you, Jesus. That's where I'm going, 1 Timothy chapter 1. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
When you preach about holiness, people that are shocking of committing adultery and fornication and homosexuality, they hate you. Not because of you, but because of what you're saying. It's not, they don't want a change. And you're killing them by telling them what the Bible says. Let's look at verse 3, 1 Timothy chapter 1, starting from verse 3. As I heard you when I went into Macedonia to stay in Ephesus, so that you may command certain people not to teach false doctrines any longer. You have to command certain people not to teach false doctrines any longer. People enjoy false doctrine. Doctrine that will make you comfortable and see people enjoy. Doctrine that will include everything. No matter what you do, you just be okay with God. God is love. God just love everybody. God love everybody, but God hates sin.
Yeah.
God loves sin, but God hates sin. You need to understand it.
Yeah.
That's why Christ came.
Yeah.
For this reason, the Son of Man was manifest, that he might destroy the work of the devil. That's why Christ came. Thank you, Jesus. Time to stop teaching false doctrines and no longer, or to devote themselves to myths and endless genealogies such as promoting controversial speculation rather than according to God's work. When you begin to teach things that make people comfortable with their sin, you're teaching a false doctrine. God said, don't do that. Teach what's in line with what the Bible says. Thank you, Jesus, which is by faith. Verse 5, the goal of this command is love. We come from a pure heart. The goal of this command is what? Love. We come from what? A pure heart. How can the heart be pure when we do our own thing? Unless you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in our heart that God has raised him from the dead, we shall be saved. For with the heart, man believes unto righteousness. So blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. How can the heart be pure? Because the word of God is what makes a pure heart. The work of the Holy Spirit. The work of the Holy Spirit. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, is a new creature. All things have passed away, all things have become new. God said, I'm going to take away the stony heart from you, and I'm going to give you a heart of flesh. A heart that is sensitive to the Holy Spirit. The day you hear his voice, you're not hardening your heart. So it has to do with the heart. Man look on the heart of the appearance, but God look in the heart. If the heart is not right, there's nothing you can do to make it right. God is not someone to come to repair your heart. He's someone to give you a new heart. A new heart and a new spirit will I give to you.
Yes.
Unless you have a new heart, it'd be impossible to live right. It'd be impossible not to walk in perversion. You look at somebody who's killing us. God knew that. God didn't want to refurbish your heart. He wants to give us a new heart.
Yeah.
Therefore, if any man be in Christ, it's a new creature. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. And all things are of God who has given us the ministry of reconciliation.
Yeah.
And he has committed us to the word of reconciliation. If you give us the ministry of reconciliation, what kind of reconciliation? To bring people from their sin back to God. How can we bring people to God when we're walking in sin ourselves? The goal of this command is love. We come from a pure heart and a good conscience and a sincere faith. The goal of this commandment is what? Love. We come from a pure heart. Love, we come from a pure heart. Love, we come from a pure heart, not perversive heart. Unless our heart is submitted to God, unless we humble our heart before God, then the heart is perverse. When the heart is perverse, then all the only thing we can do is tit for tat. Somebody do you wrong, do them wrong back. You work in unforgiveness, you work in bitterness, you work in everything else. It's not something that you put in your mouth that defies a man. It's something that comes out of your mouth.
Yeah.
What comes out of you comes from the heart. So it's a heart issue. Hallelujah. I can dress and look nice and everything. If the heart is not right, everything is not right. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
That's why a lot of people married are very, very selfish. They think about themselves only because their heart is perverse.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. Their heart is very perverse.
Yeah.
They are desperately wicked. And the Bible says nobody can change it. Nobody can repair it. You've got to give me a new heart. Thank you, Jesus. God of this command is love. God of this command is what? Love. So God commanded to love. It's not optional. You cannot hate people. Say, well, God told us to love, but right now the way I feel from what they did to me, I don't really feel it. But just told God, well, you know more than him. God said, if you love me, keep my commandments. God said, if you love me, keep my commandments. If they have my commandments and keep them, this is First John. This is John chapter 14. Let's take a look at John chapter 14. Oh, I'm sorry. Before you go, let's finish this. The goal of this command is love will come from a pure heart and a good conscience and sincere faith. Some have departed from this and have turned to meaningless talk. They want to be teachers of the law, but they do not know what they are talking about or what they so far have finally confirmed. Hallelujah. They don't know what they're talking about. They want to be teachers of the law. They just don't do what the Bible says. They teach it, but they're not working with God.
Hey,
Lord. They are supposed to be teachers. They can teach well. They just can't work with God.
Hey, Lord.
I was at the convention a long time ago, and this guest speaker spoke so profoundly. It was a life-changing experience. I mean, it was a very powerful life-changing experience. At the end of the time, it's like, why do you wait to go and encourage you to tell him, hey, that was powerful. I really appreciate you. I went and got to the guy, but look at him like, who are you? You better get away from me. Okay. God really bless you. Why am I saying this? It's not enough to preach profoundly. You have to live what you preach.
Yes.
Amen.
I was shocked. I was very shocked. I was going to go there to encourage the guy. I got to him like, why are you talking to me? Kind of thing. I walked away quickly. So what I just listened was a show then. For the blind Bartimaeus, son of David, have mercy upon me. On the way to Jericho. They told him to shut up, be quiet. They told him to shut up. He cried out some more. Then Jesus stood. I said, what do you want? What can I do for you? So there are people that preach the word, but they're not a people person. Why are you preaching to people if you don't like him? If you don't like people, why are you preaching to them? Are you just doing it because it's a good vocational to do? Or did God call you to do it? If God called you to do, you have a heart for people. If you didn't call you to do it, it'd be a vocation.
Yeah.
So when you finish preaching, you turn off the anointing, that's it. You go back to your main self.
Wow. Wow.
Got a switch. I was on while I was preaching. Don't know that I'm off now. You better get it from me. Can catch me when I'm on. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
Glory be to God in the highest, and happy be unto all men. On whom is favor rest. Let's take a look at 1 Peter chapter 3. 1 Peter chapter 3, 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 15. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We have to love people the way God loves them.
Thank
you, Jesus. 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 15. He said, but in your heart, revere Christ. Revere Christ. Respect God in your heart. I said, respect God in your heart. There are some things I will not do when I have to do with God. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
I respect God in my heart. Some people are just, they pray, they will cross their leg, I've been watching television, I'm eating burger, Lord, just thank you. I will be on the restroom, flushing, Lord, thank you.
Oh.
Anytime you pray, you invoke the presence of God to be there. I said, every time you pray, you invoke the presence of God. If you need to hear from God, why are you folding your leg and watching Days of Our Life and flipping the channel and just thinking? Because you make it a routine. You got used to God.
Yes.
You don't expect him to say anything to you because you have no time for him. I can get, if you're watching Days of Our Life or you're watching whatever you're watching and chewing something and crossing your leg and flipping the channel, just thank you. Why do you intend to hear from him? Because even if he's speaking, you won't hear. Because the man is on the tube and everything.
Yeah.
Food in the mouth, man in the tube, crossing your leg. No reverence for God. Just whatever you feel like doing. If you pray, oh yeah, just pray. You want me to show you the video of what it looks like when you are praying? But in your heart, revere, respect God. Say, respect God.
Respect God.
God is not my body, body. Jesus doesn't talk to me anyhow.
Amen.
Sometimes I have a bad attitude. If you don't do what you want, if you don't do what we think you ought to do, and you ought to do, if you have a bad attitude. Somebody told me, well, I'm mad at God right now. I said, you? You a mere man? I said, why you are mad at God? Can I ask you something? So one day I said, can you please give him his spirit and his breath? So you can get mad with him because it belongs to him. If you're able to say I'm mad at God, guess who gives you the breath? God. So give him his spirit and give him his breath. So he can really mad. If you're really, really mad, give him his spirit back and give him his breath back. Rest of you can be mad in the cemetery. It's a stupid thing to say you're mad with God. Very, very stupid thing.
Yeah.
God knows all things, we don't know all things. We need to understand that God is not our body body. God is the Almighty.
Yes.
And you respect him.
Yes.
You honor him. He loves to be respected. He's worthy of praise. He said, in your heart, revere Christ as God. If you don't honor Christ as God in your heart, he can do anything you want to do. And there'll be no remorse or anything. Why? Because you don't revere him. Let me tell you something about God that's very interesting. God is omnipresent. He's in every place at the same time. I used to work with a lady long time ago, and she was going to go to Disneyland or Disney World in Florida. She was unsafe, so she was packing a G-string and everything she was going to do. All of a sudden, her mother said, "Daughter, I want to go with you this time." She said, she was talking to some of her friends, just happened to overhear them. She said, "If I take a G-string and my mother saw me, she'd kill me. I have to change the wardrobe now. I cannot take everything I wanted to take because my mother was going." Everywhere you go, God is going with you.
Yeah.
Amen.
That's what remember in your heart, revere Christ as God. In your heart. Understand that God is in every place. There's nothing you can do that God is not there. Hello?
Yes.
There's no way you can do that God is not there.
Right.
So if you revere God in your heart, then whatever you do, be mindful that God is with you.
Yeah.
That will help us not to go wild when nobody is watching but God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. It's not for condemnation. It's for you to just be aware of a Christian life.
Mm-hmm.
If you make up your mind you're going to be a Christian, then that's what you require to be a Christian. Align, be God conscious. Revere Christ as God in your heart. Humble yourself, humble your heart before God. Let God be God for a change. Don't be doing things that God doesn't like. See, some people, the fear of man will bring a snare.
Mm-hmm.
The fear of man will bring what? A snare. You know what a snare is? Something terrible thing. If only you have the fear of man, when we're together, we do right, and we're not together, we do everything you feel like doing. Because nobody's watching.
Yes.
When we see a Christian, you have to understand that to become a Christian, you accept Christ as the Lord and Savior. So where does he live? Inside of you. How often? Permanently. Does he take a break? No. Does he take a vacation? No. Does he go? How about if you're on vacation? For the mystery of the gospel is Christ in you, the hope of glory. You have hope in every situation. Thank you, Jesus. In your heart, revere or reverence God, Christ as God. Always be prepared to give the answer to everyone who asks you to give the reason for the hope that you have. So as a Christian, you must always have hope. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. A psychologist did a test. They said there's an advantage to being a Christian. So what is it? Because Christians don't commit suicide. Why? Because they understand that they have Christ in them. They have a hope. They understand that you don't do anything to your own body that belongs to God. Hallelujah. So the people say, wait a minute, how can you say this? That's part of the doctrine of a true Christian. They don't go and do whatever they feel like doing with their own body. Because your body belongs to God. And a true Christian will not be going through all these things trying to live that they have no hope, trying to give up on life. You can't give up on life when you have Christ in your life.
Yeah.
Who is Christ?
Oh,
yeah. How much power does he have? Does he know everything about you?
Yeah.
Can he make any change in your life? Is it powerful enough to make a change for better?
Wow, it's quiet.
I think I hit a nerve. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
He alone is worthy to be praised. Worthy to be praised. Thank you, Lord. God said, I want your heart. God said, I want your heart. I want your heart. And he said, Lord, you know something? You found me. Lord, please forgive me for living a ragged life when I think nobody's watching. I think I'm getting away. That's because I've not met God yet.
Yeah.
If you know who God is, and God is omnipresent, is in every place, the way to live a life according. It says it is about your heart. Revere God. Reverend God. What does it mean to reverend God? To be God instant-minded. To be aware that God is with you wherever you go. So wherever God is not going, don't go.
Amen.
I said, wherever the word of God is against, do not go. Because if you go, you're going against what you're born again. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. He alone is worthy.
Yeah, Lord.
Worthy to be praised. We live in a time that is very, very rough time. People are making all kind of laws and all kind of rules. Just because somebody is in love doesn't mean it's godly.
Amen.
In California, they have a bill, AB 2943, to outlaw Christians and other people that want to help. That means if somebody is a homosexual or they're struggling with their gender identity, they cannot go to Christian or pastor to counsel them to help them. It'd be against the law. LGBTQ made that law. They rally around and tried to pass that law in California. So somebody struggling with their identity and they need some help, they said Christians cannot help them, pastors cannot help them. People agree with abortion. They say it's pro-choice. The Bible says, I plead before you life and death. It's either life or death. There's no choice in between.
Right.
If you kill a child, it's death. If you carry a baby, it's life. So, what's the solution to all this is abstain from sexual immorality. Abstain, hold your horses.
Amen.
If you don't get a horse, we'll get a horse for you. Hold your horses. Sometimes we just go all the way against God.
Yes, sir.
Devil will say, well, since you're pregnant, you might say, I bought the baby. Like, you know, mother, I'll tell you. Are you listening to me?
Yes, sir.
Abstain. Say, Lord, keep me. I want to be kept. God kept me for 10 years, celibate, before I met my wife. I'm not ashamed of it. But I'm so grateful I've been married to my wife almost 23 years. We're still in the honeymoon stage. Every time I look at my wife, I still got a butterfly in my stomach.
Oh.
I said, Lord, I thank you. I want to be kept. God will keep you from the kept.
Yes, he will.
You cannot keep a man by fooling around with them.
That's right.
You just lower your value to a low for
right.
Less than low for prayer.
That's right.
You don't keep a man by you know what I'm talking about. Thank you, Jesus. Abstain. Don't let anybody deceive talking about I can keep a man. No, you won't. It's too cheap. People are looking for people that are clean. And I have men and women messing around. He said, when are you going to get married? Yeah, 2090. If you're getting a free meal, go buy a cow.
Right.
The devil is a liar.
Abstain!
You're a royal priesthood. You're a holy nation. You're a peculiar people. You have to call out of darkness into the marvelous light. You belong to God. Without holiness, no man shall see you. You are wonderful. Fearfully and wonderfully made. You are the elect of God. You have been washed. You have been sanctified. You have been justified. You have been redeemed. You have been set free. You belong to God. Hallelujah. I say you belong to God.
Amen. Hallelujah.
God said, I got a plan for your life. Don't let the devil mess it up.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Test drive. Go to the test drive and get pregnant, then try to decide what to do with the baby. Well, you have to have the baby now, you can't kill the baby again. Because you compound the trouble by killing the baby.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Got pregnant or wedlock that trying to kill the baby to go with it. You might as well. That's the devil tell you. Well, you might as well since you already. Well, you know, people are going to see you with this. People are going to. So just kill. Go ahead and murder. Make it more complex. Get away from God. You'll be standing before God. Looking at him face to face. Say, why did you do that? You tell me. You gave me the power to take somebody else's life.
Mm.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
People don't get pregnant by mistake. There are things not supposed to be doing. If you're doing it and you're not married, guarantee. Sometimes I don't even be pregnant. It may be STD. Okay, I'm a thing that don't have a name yet. Serenity. Can be sterile. Chlamydia doesn't have a symptom, but you can't have a child. Because stay there long enough, try to have a baby, can't have a baby when you're ready. You're not a demo, you're a new creation.
Yeah.
I say you're not a demon. You're a new creation in Christ.
Hallelujah.
You belong to God. A true love is a willing sacrificial giving of myself for the benefit of another without expecting anything in return. They left me hanging today. They didn't want to say it. Did you hear anybody say it with me? Nobody said this to me today. A true love, is a willing
sacrificial giving of myself,
For
the benefit of another without expecting anything in return.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. With the holiness so much, I see God. I feel I'm preaching now. You belong to God. God belongs to you. God has a vision for your life. The thought of God towards you is of peace and not of evil, to give you the expected end. God says, I love you with an everlasting love. It belongs to me, and I belong to you. You are more than conqueror. You are more than loving it. You are the head of the tail. You do all things together. Thank you. It's the glory and the gift of our head. It's the author and the finisher of our faith. You are more than conqueror.
Lord,
you are fearfully and wonderfully made.
Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Virtue. You got virtue.
Amen.
You got virtue.
Amen.
You belong to God.
Amen.
God will keep you from the beginning.
Yes.
Don't worry about what happened in the past. I'm not here to preach the message of condemnation. I'm here to preach with the conviction. Forgetting those things which are behind. I'm praying to those which are before. First of all, it was a matter of the high calling of Lord. You pray for your life. Don't look back. Wrestle with your life now.
Yeah.
I agree with God. Go with God the way. Let Holy Ghost come. You found me.
Yeah.
You are in the valley of the shadow of death. I fear no evil. But I ask with me. You run like a sound to comfort me. I belong to God.
Yeah.
I can do all things through Christ that faith with me. And my purpose is and open me. And to hope and not to save. So when most of the things are prosper, I have the mind of God. I agree with God.
Hallelujah.
There's not much I see, God.
Yeah.
What is going to heaven is in the hand basket. Why in the way? People say they are just living a very shabby life, just living, sleeping around and sliding and everything else. Where is God? Where is God in your life?
Yeah.
Who is he?
Yeah.
You respect him?
Yeah.
Then stop.
Yeah.
And say, Lord, keep me, I want to be kept.
Hallelujah.
Preach it, Pastor.
My God.
God says, I'm reserving you for the best.
Yeah.
Some of the prince and kings and queens, and you act like a peon, because you don't know who you are.
Mm.
Born again, watching the blood of the Lamb, and sitting in the gutter. Like a drunk man, sitting in the gutter. You belong to God.
Yeah.
I say you belong to God.
Yeah.
I say you belong to God.
Yeah. My God.
There's a shortage in the church, but not in the kingdom. In the church, all you gotta do is turn away from my wicked ways and turn towards God and confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in my heart that God has raised him from the dead. Bingo, I'm saved now. To be in the kingdom, you have to be obedient to God in your heart.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yes. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So it's time to change the foundation. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
The ladies know about this. If you used to having the foundation before you have the makeup, when there's no foundation, it kind of look funny somehow. If the foundation be destroyed, what can the rest of do?
Uh-huh.
Foundation of Christianity is holiness.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Are you with me?
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
You know about foundation, ladies.
Yeah.
If you don't know about makeup, foundation is good, everything will work out. It will look beautiful. If you miss the foundation, well, it might not look as good. If the foundation be destroyed, what can the rest of do? So the foundation for Christian is a walk with God. Born again and a walk.
Hallelujah.
God bless you.
Hallelujah.